The following is a production of Learfield Sports.
The Badgers took another step closer to winning a Big Ten championship on Saturday with a 63-53 victory against Minnesota. Wisconsin improves to 13-1 in Big Ten play, a three-game lead with four conference games remaining. Josh Gosser hit a milestone. He's now in rare air. He and Michael Finley are the only two Badgers ever with 1,000 points, 500 rebounds, and 250 assists. Pretty good company, I would say, as the Badgers improve their winning streak to 10 games. We'll hear from head coach Bo Ryan, some of the players, and we'll also get up close with Jordan Smith. It's all coming up on today's edition of the Badger Sports Report. From time to time, but now releases off of that pressure, and Koenig brings it to the front court, finds a back-cutting Decker to the rim, two-hand slam dunk, Sam Decker. Left of the lane, back out the hill, wide pass, stolen away by Decker. Here's Sam with a run out, down the lane, to the rim, and he rips it through with a right hand. Sam Decker with another hard punch.
And knocked away by Koenig, and Bronson gets the steal. Turnover Penn State, Koenig to the offensive end. He'll drop it back to Kaminsky. Frank on the right-hand dribble, down the lane, slam dunk with two hands from Frank Kaminsky. Taking it hard to the rim on the flush. It's 11-6 Wisconsin.
Josh Gosser will throw it to Koenig high on the right. Nate Mason defending. Koenig will snap off a three, and it's good. Bronson Koenig, who as a starter is shooting 48% from the three-point line. Shot fake, moves to his left off the Kaminsky screen. Three in the air, left of the circle, short, no good. Hayes the tip up and in. Nigel Hayes with the tip in off the miss. Between the rings, feeds Koenig left of the circle into Gosser. Posting on Hollins, left block. Josh turns, goes up, low on the left, good. And that's 1,000 for Josh Gosser. The third Badger this season to hit that milestone. But Gosser is also in a party of two. He and Michael Finley, the only Badgers ever with 1,000 points, 500 rebounds, and 250 assists.
It's nice. I mean, we got the win. I know it's cliche, but it's not really something that's I'm thinking about at all. We got bigger things to worry about. You know, I know Frank and Sam thought the same way when they got there. So it's great. You know, in a month or two, in a few months, my career's over, and I can look back and everything that's going on. I'll be proud of it. But right now, we got bigger fish to fry.
Gosser, top of the circle. Finds it. Kaminsky in the lane, nice feed, Dukin, shot fake left, fake that right, takes it left and lays it in. Nice work by Dukin inside, nice work by the Badgers all around. Decker on the dribble to the line, down the lane, slam dunk, winds up, pounds it down. Two-hand slam dunk for Sam Decker.
Down the lane, right hand, slam dunk, Sam Decker.
And that's the record. Frank Kaminsky, 43 points.
Nigel, up he goes, and he throws it down.
Stamps off a three, left of the circle, book it. High screen, Kaminsky, trade driving left lane line. To the rim, scoops it up and into the right hand.
Bo Ryan and the Wisconsin Badgers have punched their ticket to Texas. They're going to the Final Four.
The Badger Sports Report with Bo Ryan is brought to you by Charter Communications. By the Dairy Farm Families of Wisconsin, the Wisconsin Milk Marketing Board. By Zimbrick Buick GMC. By Adidas. And by UW Health, a cornerstone partner of Wisconsin Athletics.
Most people don't know that UW Health and the University of Wisconsin are national leaders in the field of kidney transplant. They provide new life for those who will likely die without a transplant, and they assure a normal life for those who donate. I would know. I donated a kidney, and together we saved a life.
UW Health, remarkable.
When you have the fastest internet speeds, you can find anything almost instantly, which is a powerful thing. Because sometimes it's not so much what you're looking for, but how fast you can find it that makes all the difference. Get the most advanced fiber network, Charter Spectrum. Where will it take you?
the pride that it takes to run a farm, how you maintain your land, how you maintain your farm, how you do all those things. It's obviously a huge component of our state. It's funny, whenever you're out in different areas of the country, everybody will say, it's all cheese, milk, dairy. That's kind of what people associate Wisconsin with. And we take great pride in being the dairy state and being a big producer for the rest of our country for the products that we produce.
Introducing the starting lineup at Zimbrick GMC.
Whether you use your truck for work or play, GMC's full line of trucks, crossovers, and SUVs will handle it with style. Built with your comfort in mind and all the power you'll need to get the job done right.
No matter what the season, you'll always get a great deal at Zimbrick GMC. Zimbrick GMC is a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Visit Zimbrick GMC today.
Johnson probing off a Kaminsky screen, moving to his left, back out to Frank, pass went through his hands, but Decker's there, five to shoot. Sam, left-hand dribble to the line, in the lane, to the rim, layup good, it counts, and a foul. Shot clock winding down, Sam Decker said, I got it, and he does. It's an and one, Donovan Jack with a foul.
Into the home stretch now of the Big Ten season, the Badgers will be at Maryland on Tuesday night, a 6 o'clock tip down at College Park, and then believe it or not, the final home game of the regular season will be on Sunday, the Badgers at home against Michigan State. But we'll look ahead a little bit later. Let's turn back the clock a little bit. Go back to this past Wednesday night. The Badgers were in State College taking on Penn State. And per usual, a very hard-fought game there against the Nittany Lions. Now, Bo, your teams have been able to take care of business there the last few years, but it's like you expect it. You don't want to assume things, but I guess if you're going to assume something there, it's going to be a very difficult game to win, right?
Well, and then if you throw in the circumstances that occurred in the game prior, there were a couple calls that were debated. Is that the best way
to
put it?
That's a good
way. So Penn State was a little bit upset about certain calls, and actually they had to pay a fine and things like that. So we knew that they were going to come out with something to prove, and Penn State gave us all. They made us handle them offensively and defensively at a very high level. So for us to get in there and get one, I thought that was really a good job done by our players.
I would imagine there are teams that would say this about trying to guard your guys, where you could do just about everything right, but your guys are going to score. If it's Frank, Sam, whoever. I look at it from an opponent, a DJ Newbill. Would I be right in saying that defensively, there are times when you can do everything textbook, but he's just so good, he's going to find a way to put it in the hole.
Yeah, and he was bound and determined. And again, we just wanted to try to make sure that somebody else on the team also, that there wasn't a second and third scorer to contribute to what he was doing, because he has gone in stretches against us where he couldn't miss, and he's gone in stretches where he couldn't hit. So he definitely was on Wednesday night.
Your guys do such a good job here throughout the course of this season. The point differential, it's like plus 13, whatever, which is far better than anybody else in the Big Ten. But when other teams make a run, if it's at Nebraska or at Penn State and the students are getting into it, you guys kind of, they're not all veterans here, but those who are kind of maybe lead the way there, don't they?
Yeah, so far they've been able to handle that. And every team's going to make runs, and it's not usually just one. It's usually a couple. And same thing for us, and you try to sustain it when you're going through it for your team, and you try to cut into it and eliminate it when the other team's on one, and that's all part of the game. And then in the final analysis, everybody has their stats, and it tells a story, but within that story, the chapters can be a lot different.
There's so many, I don't know how many times I've said this year, an opponent, probably not very many, actually, where they feel like they've done a pretty good job against somebody as good as Frank Kaminsky, and then if you look at the numbers at the end of the game, it's 16-9, or he might have a double-double against somebody else. But I guess, all things considered, if you're the other guy, that's not bad. That's just how good that Frank is.
Yeah, and how our guys are willing to share the ball, too, in that Frank's usually getting his numbers not based on a high volume number of shots, or anybody else. They share the ball well, and if somebody finds himself open and they get 15 shots in a game, that's fine. Or they can get five shots in the game, still end up with double figures, and maybe it's because somebody else was hot. So that's what I like about our guys.
Speaking of Frank, and we'll throw Sam in here as well, a couple more Badgers are up for some major awards. College basketball will have an awards show in April. And, of course, those guys, in addition to yourself being a finalist for the Naismith Hall of Fame, which that's still kind of fun to say. I would imagine it's fun to be. We'll find out in April about that. But it's just tremendous. And I know so many people are thrilled around here and very proud of you. And your guys through the years, and this year with Sam and with Frank. Frank is on the shorter list for the Kareem Abdul-Jabbar Award as the best center in college basketball, and Sam is on the Julius Erving Award, symbolic of the best small forward. It's kind of funny. You know, the Cousy Award has been around for a while. Now Jerry West, Karl Malone, they'll have awards named after them. It's kind of fun, isn't it, for those who remember seeing those guys play?
Well, yeah, especially for someone my age, and since I am on the Cousy selection panel,
right,
which has always been neat over the past few years, I guess for probably the last 10 years, it's been really good. And paying homage to the older guys, the ones that made the league what it is and that sort of thing, that's all good stuff.
Mm-hmm. It is. And certainly congratulations to this point for players such as Frank Kaminsky and Sam Decker and their recognition and all the guys. And obviously the very much team awards, and they'd be the first to tell you that. They're about bigger things than the individual awards, but as you would say, it's fun to have them in Wisconsin playing those guys.
Sure,
so that's a good thing. Coach Ryan returns in a few minutes with a great day and great question of the week. Stay with us as the Badger Sports Report continues.
It's 2050. I'm one of 9 billion people on the planet. Like most, I live in a city. Our air and water are clean, and there's plenty of fresh food for everyone. My parents are getting old, but staying healthy. Good thing, because my kids will probably live to be 100. Can you imagine?
The University of Wisconsin-Madison, preparing minds to meet the challenges of the future before they become the challenges of today. Keep on, Wisconsin. Keep on.
Frank to the line. Frank in the lane. Spin move. Up right hand and in. Kaminsky getting some work done in the paint. Right block. Quick turn. Guns it out to Koenig. Green ball. Left pocket. It's good. Koenig with 13.
50. In February is a grind. Once you get to the middle, towards the end of the Big Ten season, I mean, every game is tough. It's physical. You're traveling throughout the week. Playing multiple games a week. But, I think we're playing okay. We still haven't quite put together full 40 minutes of good basketball, but that's hard to do in this league. So, we're obviously happy with the way we're playing, considering we're coming out with wins. But we still got to get better if we want to get what we want. So we did a pretty good job today. I haven't quite looked at the numbers yet, but, we did a better job in there. Leading scorer as opposed to the last game. We're getting better. We're definitely getting better. It's still about putting a 40-minute effort in. We still had a couple turnovers that led to easy buckets for them and gave them a couple things too easy. But overall, I'm satisfied.
I thought we did an okay job of kind of just slowing down a little bit, not letting their pressure get to us. Like we were just talking about using ball fakes, shot fakes, stuff like that. And I thought we did a good job of handling the pressure on the press, kind of breaking it and making them go back and play man-to-man. I thought we did a good job of making them play half-court. So, but I didn't think we did as good of a job, me personally as well, with handling the ball.
Shot fake, moves to his left off the Kaminsky screen, three in the air, left of the circle, short, no good. Hayes the tip up and in. Nigel Hayes with the tip in off the miss.
I didn't know they were my rebounds, but yeah, Nigel's getting on the glass. He's making things happen. That Penn State game, he really got on the offensive glass. And today, he had some lucky tip-ins, but he was definitely getting there, and he had a chance to get the ball, so he's putting himself in the right positions. We felt in control pretty much the whole second half. We knew they were trying to catch us the whole time, and we were getting some easy buckets and scoring and running some clock on offense. So it was just one of those games where we got the lead and we never looked back and tried to grind it out from there. It'll be a good test for us where we are going into tournament time. We're playing, probably, like you said, the toughest part of our schedule in the Big Ten coming up. So we're excited for the challenge and we're going to do whatever we can to come out on top.
traditional octopus salad, drizzled with some olive oil and topped with a dash of salt and pepper.
It's funny how seeing a clearer picture can lead you to see the bigger one. Get the most HD channels and the fastest internet on the most advanced fiber network, Charter Spectrum. Where will it take you?
Some call it a miracle. Others call it science. But for those who've needed a kidney transplant like Kelly Krager, they simply call it a new lease on life. For nearly five decades, UW Health and the University of Wisconsin have been national leaders in the field of kidney transplant, providing a new life for recipients and assuring a normal life for living donors. Miracle? Science? Maybe it's a little bit of both. UW Health. Remarkable.
Introducing the starting lineup at Zimbrick GMC.
Whether you use your truck for work or play, GMC's full line of trucks, crossovers, and SUVs will handle it with style. Built with your comfort in mind and all the power you'll need to get the job done right.
No matter what the season, you'll always get a great deal at Zimbrick GMC. Zimbrick GMC is a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Visit Zimbrick GMC today.
Learfield Sports Directors Cup is the officially sanctioned annual award recognizing all-around excellence in men's and women's collegiate competition. NACTA and USA Today co-founded this esteemed honor in 1993, still widely recognized as the crowning achievement in college athletics.
George Marshall to the forecourt. 12 points. He's 4 of 6 from downtown in this game. Manning to Showalter. Nice feed inside. Jordan Smith low on the right. Layup good.
I think it's gone well. I mean, you know, we've got a ton of guys back this year. We only lost really one guy that played last year. So, I mean, your expectations aren't huge to come in and to play a ton. And I think we've done exactly what I thought, I guess.
It's got to feel good not redshirting this year and knowing that the chance for those minutes are out there.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's exciting just knowing that there's a possibility of getting in every night. I mean, especially now we're all playing really well, so there's a good chance every night that you're going to get to play in front of some people, which is really nice.
So the more that the starters rack up the points,
More
you're sitting
on
the bench.
Yeah, exactly. You're like, all right, come on, keep it going.
So in your best interest to keep the foot on the gas pedal as long as possible.
Exactly.
You don't want any of these teams cutting into the lead at the last second. Right?
Exactly.
What are some things personally that you're working on this year to improve yourself as a basketball player?
You know, the one main thing is my ball handling that I've really been working on for the past, you know, a couple of years, but I've really made an emphasis to get better this year because, you know, you see in the Big Ten, you got to be really strong with the ball to get inside. You can't just be a one-dimensional shooter, so you got to be able to put the ball on the floor and make moves to the basket, which that's really been my focus.
And how would you assess your role, or what would you describe your role as on this team and the scout?
Oh, a shooter. Definitely a shooter. I mean, I've played the shooter on every team since freshman year, so I'd say that's, I mean, eventually if I do start playing some minutes on this team, I would think it'd be the same thing as going in as a shooter. But like I said, it's important to be well-rounded and to be able to go in and put shot fake and put the ball on the floor and everything like that too.
What's your favorite player maybe from an opposing team that you get to emulate?
Oh, it was definitely Marshall Henderson. Our sophomore year, I think that was. It was basically every time he touched the ball, just shoot it. So that was really fun.
You have connections with John Lohr from high school and Ruzewicz from AAU.
Mm-hmm.
What are some things maybe that they told you that maybe convinced you to come to Wisconsin, or some things that you learned about basketball from them?
Well, you know, John, I was playing with John in high school when I was in eighth grade, and, you know, he just really kind of took me under his wing and showed me the way to play with bigger guys and better, and not better, but bigger, stronger guys. And so he really taught me how to do that. And then Mike just kind of, you know, he kind of had that built-in family when he got here, which was a plus for me because I'd spent the last 3 years playing AAU and staying in the same hotel and getting to know him. So that was just kind of a comfort blanket for me when I got here.
Frank said that you would be the best man at his wedding. What is the what's the story behind the off-court chemistry between you two?
I mean, you know, it's kind of hard to explain. That's why everybody you get asked that, like, how does it, like, you don't really know how to explain how you become friends with someone. It's just kind of, it just happens. I just said, you know, you can spend that much time together and not want to beat the crap out of each other. It's like, hey, that's friendship right there. You go to movies, it's just me and him, and it's like people look at you like you're weird, but it's like, this is what we do. We go to movies together, we're friends.
He's called you his voice of reason. Yeah. What does that entail?
Just keeping him down to earth, you know, he's blowing up a little bit, and for the most part he does a pretty good job staying down to earth and staying humble, but you know, I just throw little jabs in there at him, like when he scored his 43 last year, I had to say, hey, you know, I scored 49 in high school when I was a sophomore, so whatever. And then, you know, if I see a magazine with him on the cover, if he's in it, I'll bring it home. I'll be like, hey, dude, that's you. Look, check it out. And he always gets embarrassed. So it's kind of funny. I'm making calls for him, putting calls into GQ, trying to get him in that one. He'd probably say I'm dirty, just like any other roommate. But he really thinks that he blames most things on me when really, in fact, it might not be my fault. But, you know, he likes to pass off the blame on me most of the time. So that's probably the one thing he'd say about me, unfortunately.
And Frank's running out of eligibility, but you're still going to be around. So yeah. You're putting out flyers, maybe?
Roommate search, right?
Yeah. That's going to be weird. Or something.
We've thought about it. We had that issue last year, and we lost George for a roommate. So I've thought about putting out flyers and stuff, but no, it'll be fine. I'm going to live by myself next year, kind of chill out, just not have everybody over all the time, and just have a low-key senior year. For this year, you know, it's just to help out in any way that I can. If it's playing the other team's shooter, if it's giving the guys a good look defensively, if it's doing whatever I can, if it's going in, if someone gets in foul trouble, and just playing a few minutes here and there and helping out just any way that I possibly can, that's obviously the best thing you can do for the team.
Introducing the starting lineup at Zimbrick GMC. No matter what the season, you'll always get a great deal at Zimbrick GMC. Get to Zimbrick GMC today and score big savings. Zimbrick GMC is a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. I'm part of the Zimbrick GMC team, and you should be too. Visit Zimbrick GMC today.
When you have the fastest internet speeds, you can find anything almost instantly, which is a powerful thing. Because sometimes it's not so much what you're looking for, but how fast you can find it that makes all the difference. Get the most advanced fiber network. Charter Spectrum. Where will it take you?
Most people don't know that UW Health and the University of Wisconsin are national leaders in the field of kidney transplant. They provide new life for those who will likely die without a transplant. And they assure a normal life for those who donate. I would know. I donated a kidney, and together, we saved a life.
UW Health. Remarkable.
Whether you're out there training for a big event or you're just trying to stay in shape, I have a bit of advice. It's important to remember that what happens after the workout is just as important as what happens during the workout. My advice? Be sure to refuel with low-fat chocolate milk. It has the perfect mixture of protein, carbs, and electrolytes to help you refuel, rehydrate, and build muscle. In Wisconsin, athletes win with low-fat chocolate milk. And you can too. To learn more, visit winwithchocolatemilk.com.
The Badger Sports Report with Bo Ryan is brought to you by Charter Communications. By the Dairy Farm Families of Wisconsin, the Wisconsin Milk Marketing Board. By Zimbrick Buick GMC. By Adidas. And by UW Health, a cornerstone partner of Wisconsin Athletics.
Time now for this week's Great Dane Great Question of the Week, and we check in with Bill in Brookfield. Bill knows what is being talked about in the world of college athletics, the Big Ten, among other conferences. are at least tossing around the idea of bringing back the concept of freshmen not being eligible. You have to go back to 1972 when that changed. What are your thoughts on that, on freshman eligibility? Thumbs up, thumbs down.
Bill, I'll tell you, I was in college from 65 to 69, and I played at the institution that I attended because it was not a Division I program. It was a small college, and there are people who are ready out of high school to play. So, and handle an academic load. It's not that every player that comes out of high school needs the year. The reason I don't think it's ever going to pass is because we have 13 scholarships, and if you have a freshman class of four or five, possibly six players, it is very difficult to run a college program without using freshmen, or they would have to increase the number of scholarships, which means it would cost more money. And in this day and age, that's why I don't think it's going to happen.
All right,
it's too cost prohibitive.
Yeah, very good. All right, Bill, we thank you for your question. The Great Dane with a location up in Wausau, as well as four in Madison on the east side of town, downtown Fitchburg, as well as Hilldale. Badgers, as we said, on the road Tuesday night, 6 o'clock tip in College Park against the Maryland Terrapins. And then, believe it or not, the final home game of the season coming up on Sunday afternoon, 3 o'clock tip at the Kohl Center against Michigan State. Thanks for watching. We'll talk to you next week.
Wisconsin cheese, making good food great.
The Learfield Sports Directors Cup is the officially sanctioned annual award recognizing all-around excellence in men's and women's collegiate competition. NACTA and USA Today co-founded this esteemed honor in 1993, still widely recognized as the crowning achievement in college athletics.
It's 2050. I'm one of 9 billion people on the planet. Like most, I live in a city. Our air and water are clean, and there's plenty of fresh food for everyone. My parents are getting old, but staying healthy, good thing. Because my kids will probably live to be 100. Can you imagine?
The University of Wisconsin-Madison, preparing minds to meet the challenges of the future before they become the challenges of today. Keep on, Wisconsin. Keep on.